What was the first incident that inspired you to work for Tigers?
First incident inspiring to film on Tiger. So basically it's a big cat, and I love big cats because big cats has got a charismatic, it's a charismatic animal. And internationally lots of big cats, apart from tigers, worldwide, mainly Africa if you go, leopards and cheetahs and lions and everything is there, but tiger only in our country. So since I am from India, I just thought I'll concentrate, the tiger, which is a big cat in our country. That's the first reason. And again, big cat is worldwide, there is a great audience. Channel always looking for big cat films. That's the second reason. Third is it's a challenge to get a great story out of big cat. That's the reason. Again, it's big cat, tiger, that whole, there's a big feel. It's a big picture, a big film you can make. That's the reason.
Does it have anything to do with the extension of tigers from India and West
to Coast? If you see, if you ask me personally, most of the animals in our country is are extinction, apart from this, very basic. Most of the animals. Right from you ask in ICU and list, 70-80% of animals are in endangered version. So you can do stories on any animal. Most of them, go to Busted in Rajasthan, is endangered. So, Gadiyal in our, Chambal is extinction. Anything you call, Saras crane. If you do a complete series of films on that, different case, or keep this tiger as a centric film and do other extensions. But I somehow believe in character driven, follow one character, live with them, study them, observe them. Get the body line, get the right sequence, put together, a good sequence, and keep all these ups and downs of emotion build up. So it works because I'm basically from cinema field. Cinematic thing always works, that's what people want to see. There is no point of talking about how they mate, how they eat, conflict. And for getting into politics and poaching and stuff, which is not my scene. I look for a brilliant cinematic story which has got a great visual potential, and Ranthambhore is the best place for everything. Great backdrop, lake, tiger, cubs, grassland. So endangered is not only reason, there are other reasons.
So, sir, in your opinion, what made Machli the most popular tiger in the world?
Machli's got lot of things, not one. She's a tigress, most photographed tiger. Worldwide, lot of people know her. It's better to portray the tiger which is known to everyone so that they can relate to the tiger. That's the first reason. Otherwise, all the tigers have got great stories. So Machli's got little more because people know about her. She's killed crocodiles and the longest living wild animal. 20 years he survived in the wild, great hunter, queen of the tiger, lake, everything. She got a lot of revenue she brought. So that way it's better to, it's better to know. For example, even if you have a brilliant script in Hindi, you'd love to do a story of Salman Khan and with Amitabh, isn't it? So she's the one, even the same thing, you do a story which reaches the big mass, and so that people can relate themselves with the character. That's a simple reason. Otherwise, if you see, every tiger has got a great story. It's not that you go to Charger and MP, there's a story. You go to Tadoba, there is a great, 2-3 great characters. You go to South, Kabini, you go, there's a character. So, these characters are well known characters worldwide, and we are doing it for an international broadcast. Might as well do a story for a character which the world knows.
So, sir, you are an excellent cinematographer, so why you didn't work for Bollywood cinema?
I still work for Bollywood. I did a lot of work, not only Bollywood, in cinema, feature films. I produced films. I still work for a lot of features. I produced films. I've got a cinema in my life. In fact, the first guy who did the digital film in the country, long time back, 8 to 9 years back. Still, I'm planning to do a feature film based on tigers, so there's a great potential. And again, if you see my films also mostly, we shoot in the same sort of a technology like 4Ks and spend 2 years in high-end equipment. It's more like a cinema. If you see all my films I've received, it's written exactly put into big screen. So whether it is feature film or a documentary, I believe in strong storytelling. Strong story is important. Even today also you need a great story to do a feature film. So even in this, if you add some more characters and try to, if you've got a great story, it's the same again. So all my composition, all my, the kind of a way to visualize, mostly cinematic. It's for big screen. You project my film in the big screen and see it works.
So how will you describe your relationship with tigers?
That no tiger will ever harm you.
No tiger will harm anyone. It's a very safest animal. Never get into any conflict. And wait for the right opportunity. Till that time, it wait for it. Unless until if you go and disturb them, they might. Or they give a warning. If you don't understand, you have to face it. People like us, we mostly in the car, vehicle. For the tiger, it's always a vehicle is a huge image for them. The minute you get down, it mostly will try to run away. It's not really the attack. But again, still you go. Then they want to safeguard them. So they do it otherwise. I might be knowing the tiger or maybe shooting with them for 10 years or 9 years. That's not the thing. Not for anyone. It should not do anything.
So what are your future projects after?
Future plan is working out, follow these characters. Mm-hmm. We get great characters anywhere. I would love to do it. But still, I would like to continue this thing, the possibility, because you have got great stories, backstories still, lot of things still there to fit in. So might as well, you might end up getting a great story by compiling things or getting one thread from the older footage, something to develop that and follow it up. A lot of way to make it. Maybe we can make a series of films, or with this we can do a feature film, we can do anything. Because today digital technology, whatever you do, great content, you can do a lot of stuff. So, still exploring.
So which is the most memorable moment while filming Machli for last 9 years?
See that, obviously that not only Machli, Machli's mate, both this death sequence is a very emotional sequence, because this first time we are also seeing sitting next to the wild tiger and filming and dying in camera, filming the last breath of a tiger, which is world famous. Nothing can beat that sequence.
Have you came across a person whom you feel to transfer your tremendous talent of cinematography?
The thing is, ours is not a fixed script. We keep 4 or 5 stories when we start the film. Every day the story changes, unfolds, remove the idea of one track, add something else. Keep fermentation, combination, keep traveling with the same story, a 5-6 story plot in the mind. After 6 months, drop something, add something. So it's not, it comes from within. It's not the thing which you learn. Obviously, we know the foundation, the fundamentals, and the cinematic theory and grammar. We keep that as a skeleton and try to fit this. It's more anyone can pick it up, as long as maybe the trend changes, maybe someone can create a new trend. But for my thing is, as long as my journey of making tiger films, I made some sort of a storytelling which is character driven, which is people liking it, channels liking it, they're buying it, broadcasting it. So there is an expectation. We've seen people who still want to see it. So maybe some new trend, maybe someone can create, someone can come up with. So it's not, end of the day, if you see, it's a fundamentals are same, it's basic is same. Trying to explore it in a different perspective. Anyone can do it, I don't think. Even you can do it, anyone can do it.
sir, do you feel that government agencies cooperated you in all the tiger projects probably?
See, government agency cannot help in this because it's not a fixed thing. You go to a government, you tell them that I want this much money to produce. Not. Even when I start, till I, sometimes I got a story in 12 months, sometimes I got in 18 months. Machli I got after 9 years. How do you go and ask the government to give me this much money, I want to make a film like this for 9 years? No one gives it. So as long as government, what can do is for an Indian filmmakers, if someone is working on conservation, they can give some leverage of, you know, access in a different way. Otherwise, I don't think I have nothing to ask in government because I don't think you don't have any steady fixed plan saying that, no, I've got this much money. And government, you cannot expect government to give crores of money. And you cannot give a guarantee that government will give a film back with this. And maximum government will give 3 to 10 lakhs. You can't make a film with 10 lakhs. So it's support, the encouragement, the kind of a thing which you're giving it, as long as that is enough, it will keep. That's what I can think, because otherwise you cannot make a film the way you want if you get money from anyone else. Not only government, even the channel if it gives. You have to listen to them. You start listening to someone else. You cannot do the kind of a story which I do. The mind is focused. There's no focus, there's no fixed plans. There's a focus of this character, I need to get a brilliant story. So the brilliant story is subjective. You may like the other story, I may not like it. So till I get this right story and right sequence to put it together, I keep shooting. It's never ending. And it's a gamble. You may not get.
Last question. In your opinion, what are your suggestions for production of tigers?
Protection is a tiger. This is the best example. Machli has been protected since he is in the tourism zone. It is monitored on a regular basis. There is always someone looking around. Today is not there, tomorrow where, what. That's why she lived for 20 years. That's why she has produced 50 tigers. So, unless central volunteers or people or government set up, or, you know, they have to protect the way the tourism zone is so protected. So, or open up a little more people to monitor, or find a way to make sure they're monitoring this thing. See, in India, if you ask me, there are more number of NGOs than number of tigers. One NGO take care of one tiger, all the tigers are safe. We can create those kind of stuff.
Thank you, sir.